Good evening. Welcome to St. Andrew. We are happy that you have joined us as we celebrate our Lord Jesus Christ, King of the Universe. The lectors for this Mass are Barbara Mihalik and Bradford Grems. Our music will be led by Stefan Paul. Our cantor is Sue Schutt. Serving the Mass are Charlotte Grems, Dylan Goldsmith, and Regan Weir. The presider for this liturgy is Father Brian, assisted by Deacon Tom. To minimize distractions during the Mass, we ask that you silence all cell phones and personal devices. Now, please stand and greet your neighbor.
Exalted, the King is exalted on high. I will praise him. He is exalted forever, exalted, and I will praise his name. He is the Lord, forever his truth shall reign. Exalted on high, I will praise him. He is exalted forever, exalted, and I will praise his name. He is the Lord, forever his truth shall reign. Heaven and earth rejoice in his.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Father.
I think Stefan has a little extra energy because he's a U of M fan. But I know there's some Ohio State folks here, too. So we're going to let it go. Brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for. Father, you Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation set free from slavery may render your majesty's service and ceaselessly proclaim your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep, as a shepherd tends his flock when he finds himself among his scattered sheep, so will I tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered when it was cloudy and dark. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out, the strayed I will bring back, the injured I will bind up, the sick I will heal. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy, shepherding them rightly. As for you, my sheep, says the Lord God, I will judge between one sheep and another, between rams and goats. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
you are.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life. But each one in proper order. Christ the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. When everything is subjected to him, then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who subjected everything to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. and he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. A stranger and you welcomed me. Naked and you clothed me. Ill and you cared for me. In prison and you visited me." Then the righteous will answer him and say, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you a drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?" And the king will say to them in reply, "Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of the least brothers of mine, you did for me." Then he will say to those on his left, "Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. A stranger and you gave me no welcome. Naked and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison and you did not care for me." Then they will answer and say, "Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison and not minister to your needs?" He will answer them, "Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me." And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Paying attention to the news this holiday weekend, I understand there's going to be a record number of travelers on Sunday at Detroit Metro Airport. And hearing that news story reminded me about one of my many travels back to Michigan from someplace else. My friend Father Jim Keene and I were in line. We're in the back of the line waiting to go through the security checkpoint. And this young girl came running up, very anxious and upset. And she showed us her boarding pass, and it was very clear she really needed to be that gate as quickly as possible. So we said to her, "Well, why don't we go talk to the guard, the TSA agent, and see what we can do?" And just as he saw us step out of line, he said, "Get back in line." He couldn't have been a day over 20, but he was highly aware of his authority. And so as we approached, we said, "No, please check her boarding pass." And he said something I'm not going to say to you, but he let her go through and he scowled at us as we got back in line. And so we knew what was coming. And sure enough, as we got up there, he said, "You two have been especially selected for additional screening." And the gate went up, and we got into another line. But you know, we looked at each other and said, "Okay, this is all right. Maybe this is the line Christ wants us in today. Today, you and I celebrate Christ the King Sunday. And as we heard in our first reading, and in the beautiful psalm that was sung, our King is a shepherd. He leads, protects, and serves his people. And he calls his disciples, you and I, to also lead, protect, and serve others in his holy name. And part of that serving is being ready to respond when we are called upon. As we hear in the Holy Gospel tonight, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. A stranger and you welcomed me. Naked and you clothed me. Ill and you cared for me. In prison and you visited me. In every circumstance, in every modality of human suffering, we are called to respond. But as we all know, there are times when we don't respond as we should. And I think there are several reasons for that. First, fear. How will entering this situation, how will addressing this need affect me? Maybe I'll be late. Maybe more will be asked of me than I can give. Maybe I'll miss my flight. Whatever. A natural and human response, and one that disciples are challenged to overcome, is fear. Or perhaps our schedules, our lives are so full that there is no room to be interrupted. In one of the parishes that I worked at, the secretary would always tell new seminarians and priests who came in, my job is to be interrupted. And I've tried to adapt that attitude myself in a parish setting. I have work to do, for sure. But sometimes something comes up that needs to be dealt with. However, we can all get so busy or so preoccupied or so overextended trying to do many, many good things for ourselves and for our family that the marginal can get pushed aside and the essential missed out. Another challenge we may face is unforgiveness. At times, we've all been hurt. We all have been taken advantage of, or we've been rejected for our efforts. And if we cling to that memory, that wound, that idea, we may not respond. We may not step out in faith as we should. Recently, I went down to Slanus Casey Center and talked to the priest about this. And I was so hurt, I was explaining, how could this be God's will? Those guys are amazing. He said, this isn't God's will. How they've acted. What is God's will? To be in friendship with him. And that should affect how we treat others. If there's any unforgiveness in our heart at all, perhaps that needs to be addressed, that we may respond more freely. And finally, sometimes, quite simply, we forget. We forget that Christ is our Lord and King of the universe, and that we are beloved sons and daughters of the Heavenly Father, and that we are called with confidence, trust, and faith to respond in kind. And thankfully, the Lord gives us many wonderful examples of that. In fact, in our gospel tonight, our Lord reminds us we inherit the kingdom. We don't earn it. Like earning a place on a sports team, we inherit the kingdom because we are sons and daughters of the Heavenly Father. And with that in mind, sometimes we need to look to role models and examples that help us and encourage us. In the Catholic commentary and sacred scripture for tonight's gospel, it says the following. Few people have given themselves to the poor and forgotten like Mother Teresa. The generosity of Jesus was openly manifest through her life of untiring service to those in the most desperate situations imaginable. She knew as well as any that ministering to our fellow human beings means ministering to the Lord Jesus himself, whose image she saw on the faces of the poor. Consider her powerful words that reference our passage. In order to help us deserve heaven, Christ set a condition that the moment of our death, you and I, whoever we might have been, however we have lived, shall stand in his presence and be judged according to what we have been for the poor, what we have done for them. Christ said, I was hungry and you gave me food. He was hungry not only for bread, but for the understanding love of being loved, of being known, of being someone to someone. He was naked not only of clothing, but of human dignity and respect through the injustice that is done to the poor, who is looked down upon simply because they are poor. He was dispossessed, not only of a house made of bricks, but because of the dispossession of those who are locked up, of those who are unwanted and unloved, of those who walk through the world with no one to care for them. Do we go out to meet those? Do we know them? Do we try to find them? St. Teresa Calcutta's words resonate very well tonight as you and I now move into the final week of the church year. Let us spend some time this week reflecting on any obstacles that may abide in our lives that keep us from responding as we are called to respond. It may or may not go well. We may or may not see the fruit of our efforts. I will never know if that young lady made her connecting flight. But I do know in that moment when the Lord called us to step out on her behalf, we were doing a small part to build up the heavenly kingdom. May he use each of us this week as well to look beyond those limitations, those things holding us back, that we may respond as well and do our part to build up his heavenly kingdom. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds in the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life of the world to come. Amen. Striving always to be open to Jesus, so that he might become more and more the Lord and ruler of our lives, let us join in offering our prayers to our loving Father in heaven.
For the Holy Father and all leaders of the Church, that they may genuinely accompany the faithful, especially the youth and young adults, in service to Christ the King, let us pray. For world leaders, that their hearts may comprehend the depth of human suffering that exists and urgently strive to address the needs for food, clean water, safety, and peace for the human family, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are away from home and loved ones, particularly members of the military and relief workers, that God will preserve them from harm, give them strength for their service, and lead them home safely. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Rochester area Catholic family of parishes, may we resolve to be open to Jesus so he may become more and more each day the King and ruler of our lives and hearts. Let us pray. For all who are ill, that God's healing love may strengthen them and restore them to good health, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Deacon Donald Quigley, Blake Garrett, and those written in our Book of Remembrance, that they may inherit the kingdom of heaven in all its glory, let us pray. For the intercessions placed in our prayer basket, and for Dan and Sheila Argue, Deacon Mark and Phyllis Gemolero on their anniversaries, Ann Whedon, Manny, Janet, and Matthew Yasso, and Pete and Anna Mae Mianaki, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray.
Heavenly Father, look kindly upon the requests that we humbly bring before you. Grant them according to your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness, as eternal priest and king of the universe, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross, as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and, making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, to all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, with Saint Andrew, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession or presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. We serve in Francis, our Pope, and Eleanor Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather for yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who please your passing in this life, give kind and minister your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy a prayer of the fullest of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace and grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ has said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look down on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grace to grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed is called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Your burden's light and your yoke is easy. Your name is love and your grace is free. My heart was plucked, but you had the key. Make your home in me. Make your home. This is
Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you. Keep in mind, when leaving the Sunday 12 p.m. Mass next week, December 3rd, the parade will have Rochester Road closed. Please take side streets to leave the area. In our bulletin, there are many, many things that we are offering this week and in the season of Advent. Please spend some time with it. For example, the Rochester Community Christmas Concert is next Sunday evening, the 3rd, at 7:30 p.m. Also, we are teaming up with Holy Family Regional School and the Knights of Columbus to participate in the parade this year. They reassure me I can make the distance, so I'm going to go. And there are many other things as well, including Advent, Adoration, and Reconciliation evenings, just like our Lenten Mercy Nights that we are hosting here, and the December 9 Morning Reflection and our Advent Tea. Please call Nikki at the parish office to make a reservation for the Advent Tea. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the Master has come with justice for the world. Break into song at the deeds of the Lord, the wonders he has done in every age. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the Master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.
Take your time.
Stephen Paul.